Hello, hello, nail peoples.
Here I am. Hi, everybody. Well, let's see. Maybe I can adjust this a little bit. There we go. Oh, that's better. Hi. Hi, everybody. So I'm waiting for my trial guest to get here. It is June 16th. It's Nails Over Coffee. I'm Michelle Cortes-Pugh. And today we have the Mickey Mouse mug. Ooh, it's hot on the bottom because I have it on my ultra cool. Hi, Charlotte. Hi, everybody. I have it on my ultra cool mug warmer, so which is perfect for nail techs because then, hello. Because then it's hot when we get a chance to drink it. So here's what I'm waiting on. This is one of my trial girls from product trials. Hi. And I did a dipping nail on her before with the CYOGel, but I tried using it with an acrylic powder to see how it would work. And the good news is that it didn't lift, it didn't break, it didn't do any of that stuff. The bad news is it was a real pain in the butt to use and it's ugly. So, I'm not sure if she still has it on or not. So when she gets here, we'll know if I'm busting out some soak off bags and soaking that off before we get started or what the story is. So what I'm going to do on her though is I'm going to do, yes, you can't dip, I know that. And I didn't dip it with the acrylic, I poured it over, but it still doesn't, it didn't work right. It was just the brand of acrylic, but I have like a gazillion colors, and so I thought I better try, right? So I tried, and no, didn't work. And it made a mess in my lamp. So I'm going to use some well-less pre-etched whitest white tips on her. And this is going on my service menu as an express full set. So I sculpt everything else with my acrylics and all that kind of stuff. So I wanted something that was going to be a lower price point that was more of a for people who don't want to put their nails on and keep them on forever and ever. So yeah, the acrylic powder was messy. It's not nearly so messy when you're pouring over with a thing. So I'm going to use the CYOGel mix. Oh, hold on. Let me see if I can grab the bottles and then you can see in the actual bottles. Okay. So I'm going, yes, I have a little spoon. See, I have a spoon. So this is the CYOGel mix. And then you put it into a bottle. And then this is the CYOGel top. And it's in another bottle. And I use the CYOGel top. I actually use to seal all my enhancements because it ends up being about just under $5 a bottle for a half ounce bottle. So, and it works great and it doesn't yellow even on my pink and whites, which makes me very, very happy. So yes, we're just waiting for her to get here and then we'll be able to figure out what we're doing. There she is. Hi. Hi. I'm broadcasting. We're broadcasting your nails today. So
yeah, it works.
Yes, I actually cure all of the CYOGel for 60 seconds because I use a C&D UV lamp. So hi. So do you still have them on?
I do. They have fell apart quite a bit,
but they are on. All right. Well, that's, I said, I didn't know if we were going to have to do removal. So I was giving all of the viewers here. So you get to hear your nails will just be there, not you, but you get to hear all of my, you know, goodies. This is, we're broadcasting live on the internet.
That works.
So this is a soak up bag. This is the ones I always talk about. This is not a regular plastic bag. It's acetone proof. So let me grab some acetone. Speaking of that. Okay. So I'm going to turn the camera around and hopefully not knock you guys over. Let's see. Always fun to be trying to. All right, so we are going to take this. So yes, this was the end result of my trial with the CYOGel with tips and with the acrylic powder. It's been what, about a week and a half?
About a week and a half.
Yeah. So
Okay, so I just took acetone.
Acetone.
Oh, that was really like bam in your face, acetone, because the label was like right in the camera. And I'm going to take and plop her hand in there. And then we're just going to set down.
Okay.
And I'm actually going to take the ring off just because.
Stretchy.
Oh, good. Better. Just because I've ruined one too many rings on accident with. And so we're going to do this. I'll get you guys a better angle here in a minute. You just have to be patient. Okay. And so there you go. Elbows right. Down.
Okay.
Wrist bent. Perfect. And you can swish.
Okay.
You can swish, swish, swish. Why is this not zooming out enough for me? Okay, maybe we'll just put you there. There we go. Okay, so, when I'm doing CYOGel, I do protein bond. I use protein bond. So, yes, I do that. And, oh, you guys are funny. Hi, Tina. Got quite the little crowd in here today. So we're just going to swish. But since use non-acid primer will work better, I don't know. I've had really great luck with the protein bond so far. So I think I'm just gonna stick with that. Although I do have an acid-free primer right here. See, I have one right here. But I also have protein bond. It's a non-acid adhesion thing. So anyway. I'll use the sandy one, it'll work better. Okay, so see, then I'm going to use back scratchers, extreme glaze powder. I like this because it's super fine. So we're gonna use that, and see, it has a little scoop. See, I told you I had a spoon. Ye of little faith. So there's that. And so I've got all my stuff sitting out here ready to rock and roll. Love the scoop color. Yeah, this is the scoop that comes with the back scratcher system. So back scratchers extreme glaze system is a dipping system. They actually have a little dish that you can dip in, which is kind of cool, but you can't dip with the CYO gel because it pushes all over the place. Learned that, makes a mess. So yes, my lovely guinea pig here is nodding emphatically at that. Okay, well, I'm gonna turn you guys back around to me so you don't have to just sit and watch her. There, hi me again. Okay, so she's been in the bags for like about 2 minutes. So we're gonna wait about probably 6 more minutes or so. And then I'm going to see where we're at. So while we're swishing and waiting, it was brought to my attention today that there is a potential scam going on around out there for nail techs. So it is Love Potion number 9, and it is supposedly a kit that you get, and you just have to pay $10 for shipping. And it, when you look at the payment information, it's actually $10 three times. It's a recurring payment. $10, $10, and $10. And when you go to their website, it's a free website. There's hardly any information on it. And the manicure kit is only $25 through their little free website. And I don't know, the whole thing is just hinky. So if you are somebody who has been approached by that, you need to go into your PayPal and you need to stop the subscription because it will bill again in, you know, for another payment if you don't go into PayPal and stop your subscription. If you have been contacted but haven't done it, then don't. Because the person who was doing it has now deactivated their Facebook, and yeah, it's all no good. It's just all hinky. Although I haven't gotten any answers on if the people who paid the $10 have gotten their kits or not, or if it was just a flat out scam. But so be aware of what is going on, because that is no bueno. No bueno. I can't remember the person's name. The company was Love Potion Number 9. And nail lacquer, I think, is what it was. Is this about the love potion? Yeah, I guess. I just have been getting information about it. I wasn't approached or anything, but I got some information about it and I looked at the stuff and yeah, it's a recurring payment. So yeah, no. So you think you're paying $10 and you would pay $10, but then you would pay $10 again and again. And so unless you stopped it. So yeah, no. So whoever the scammer is who's trying to do that, right, Charlotte? What is wrong with people? Absolutely. I agree. You know I agree. Because I can't figure out what the hell is wrong with people most of the time myself. So, let's see. Anything else? It appears Chromageddon is over. Thank goodness. So, Lauren Wireman has the MSDS up from her pigment. It's actually for all 6 colors, which means not only is she going to have this chrome one, but there'll be other colors of chrome, 5 more of them actually. So she did the MSDS for all 6, and it's up on Wildflowers Academy's website, available for download now. And so that's up there, and I'm gathering MSDS sheets from all the other companies, and I'm going to feed them into the Rain Girl machine and let her pick them apart and analyze them, because that's what the stats psychology chick does. So I'm just going to feed the daughter all of the data and let her spew out the information. Let's see. Oh, and she took a foods and culture class when she was in Austria last summer. And so navigating the EU stuff is a little easier for her because she's used to it. So I'm going to, just dump that on her plate. I'll probably take the survey that we're working on back from her because I'd rather have her looking at MSDS sheets. I can do a survey. I went to school for that too. So let's see. Can't think if there's anything else going on between Chromageddon, which I don't know where that came from, but that's an awesome way to call it because it totally was. And let's see. People stop asking on Facebook groups things that require lots and lots of in-depth answers, like how should I set my prices? How much should I charge? Is this a good price for rent? That's another good one. Stuff like that. You guys, those are questions that, first of all, if you don't have the answers to those questions, then you're not ready to rent a booth. Go be an employee somewhere. Andrea asks, why not? The reason why not is because they are too long and detailed things for something like a Facebook group. First of all, you're gonna get a bunch of information from people who may or may not know what the hell they're talking about. So go out and buy Tina Alberino's book, join the University of Nails, Elaine Watson does a one-on-one thing, appointment over Skype. There's lots of options out there. So if you're going to be renting a booth, which we all know is very common in our industry now, make sure you get educated on that, because there's saying there's a lot of variance in everyone in different areas, so not everyone would be the same. And Charlotte's always a risk who you get answers from, right? So the thing is that, like, I went to college for 4 years for marketing, and pricing is part of marketing, and I still don't have all of the answers to answer that question in a Facebook group. It would take way too much. And the same thing with what price for booth rent. It depends on pricing. It depends on your area. It depends on your market. It depends on what services you offer. Like, oh my gosh, there's like a million different things about that. So, and other things. If I see one more person pop off with the question, so what acrylic is the best? I think I'm going to start punching people because, yes, calculate your costs and not just compare to other salons. Tina says business has to be planned. That's correct. And if you join the universityofnails.com, you can go through all the videos and write your business plan and your marketing plan. Just saying. For $10 a month. So if you can get it all done in a month, then it only costs you $10 to be coached through and write your business plan. I doubt you can get it done in a month, but it's possible. So maybe two. So yeah, and Tina Alberino's got a great book, and well, I will ask if I am so inclined to do so. I mean, really. Well, do it your own risk, Andrea. First of all, like I said, you don't know the quality of answers that you're getting. And second of all, you're going to get little bits and pieces, but you still don't get the whole answer and the whole picture because it's not possible to really do that within that scope. So by all means, ask if you want. I'm just not going to answer them anymore because I've spent a ton of time answering. And the Nailscape says, I think the point here is that it's been asked so many times and answered well. And Andrea says, right, but sometimes you just want to hear what people charge. Well, that's true, but if they're not in your market area, it doesn't matter what they charge. Because like Nelly charges $125 for a pedicure. I could probably charge $100 for that pedicure here. But I know people in other areas of the country that they couldn't offer that pedicure because they couldn't charge enough to be able to offer that service and make a profit on it. The products are too expensive. It takes a longer amount of time. So in some market areas where their high-end pedicures are $50, they can't do a $125 service. There won't be anybody to take it. So it doesn't matter what Nelly charges for his pedicures in Minnesota because he's Nelly and he uses his different products and he's in a different place and all that. So there's so much that goes into it. And if you want to just know what people charge, ask that question. Say, hey, I charge $40 for a full set of nails. What do y'all charge? You know, and it's sculptured and pink and white and whatever. What do y'all charge? And then get those types of answers. That will give you the same curiosity nosiness. You know, and then you can say what product do you use and how much do you charge and where are you? You know, there's other ways to ask it than just, hey, I'm just a new tech and I don't know how much I should charge for a full set. Okay, that's a really, really long answer. Okay, so I think I talked my way through. Time for me to check these bad boys out and see what we have going on. So again, yes, you totally need to be, the only other salons you need to be interested in what they're charging are the people in your immediate market area. Those people you need to know what they're charging. But okay, so let's take a gander and see what we've accomplished here. Oh goodness, this is not coming off as easily as I thought it would. I wonder if I should have broken the seal on the top coat first. Oh well, it's working now. So, yeah, I probably should have broken the seal on the top coat, I'm thinking. My bad. So, sorry. Love, you're going to be stuck in the bags for a little longer.
Okay.
Because you're willing to be my guinea pig. All right, so we'll put that back in there and keep doing that. The nice thing about doing this with the soak-off bags is it contains all of the mess. Let's see if I can get into frame here. There we go. Yeah, I didn't break the seal on the top coat, and so that is what's coming off first. And I did this with acrylic powder, which we now know makes a very ugly nail. So we're not going to ever do that again. But that's what product trials are for. Oh, I couldn't see what you guys are talking about because I was scraping. Sorry. All right. And back in the bags we go. All right, and swish. She's doing such a good job being such a good swisher. So, yeah, I didn't break the seal on the top coat. So that's one of those that when you're removing something with the CYOGel sprinkle, you need to break the seal on the CYOGel top. Otherwise, it doesn't soak off worth a boop. So, okay, so what were we talking about? Oh, we were talking about Facebook groups. So, you know, there's just some questions, and I think we just need to make sure that we're asking the actual question we want the answer to. And if the question that you want the answer to is what acrylic product should I use, then you've got some serious product testing to do. Notice I'm product testing on someone who is one of my product trials, not just putting it on my service menu and letting people who are paying me full price figure out how, for me to figure out how. And that's the other cool thing, is if you're doing product trials and then you find a product that you like, and then you go get manufacturer education from the product you've selected, so you learn all the little ins and outs of it, then you can guarantee your work because you have less repairs because you know all of the ins and outs of the product. So my screen blanked. Are you guys still there? Give me hearts. Give me hearts, because I don't know if you guys are still there. Oh, there we go. Okay. I just wanted to make sure it hadn't like frozen because it blinked on me. So yeah, you guys should really be figuring out what products you're using, and don't be quick to change products on your paying clients. Short of a supply issue, that I'm totally being a bad nail tech right now, I'm picking up my cuticle. Short of being a supply issue of something you can't get, you should be sticking with what you're normally used to using. Like, I have a primary acrylic brand and I have a backup acrylic brand in case my primary doesn't work on someone. And I have a primary gel product and I have a backup gel product in case my gel doesn't work on someone. Although I haven't had that happen yet with Masterworks, I do have a backup product. I have shellac and I have Cuccio veneer and I have take two, it's not a wrap, base coat films. So that will work on somebody. And then for nail lacquer, I have dazzle dry and I also have Cuccio color. So, you know, having that kind of, and I have that because those are brands that I know inside and out. So I can make sure that my guests are going to get what they're supposed to get. All right, I think I'm just gonna turn you guys a little bit this way while I'm pulling off bags again. So let's see where we're at. Oh, I have a cut on my finger I just found. Yummy. Okay, so I used like a burgundy color acrylic powder. And I think I'm just going to end up filing off what's left of this because it looks like I'm going to have to give it a good little file anyway. So here in a second, I'll turn you guys around and then you can see what I'm doing. And yeah, so I'm getting ready to file and stuff. So here in a minute, I'll start doing the application. So I don't know. You keep getting kicked out, Charlotte. That sucks. Well, you keep coming back though. All right, I'm gonna turn you guys around again. Turn around again. All right, there we go. And so yeah, I'm just going to, I think you can see what we've got going on here. Yeah, so I'm just gonna file the rest of that off. And now I have the camera turned as such that I actually can't see what you are saying, so. If you're going to say bad things about me, just make sure that you own up to them when I watch on the replay. Because I'll see you. I'll see you. Okay, I'm still in frame. It seems kind of blurry. You guys, is it blurry? I'm wondering if I should tap the screen to get it to focus. I'll zoom in a little closer when I'm actually doing the application.
So CYOGel is a soak off gel base that you can mix with a quality nail lacquer to create your own soak off gel polish. I've tried it for that. I did some trials on that. I believe they're on the Nails Over Coffee archive. And then see, I just bundled those all up and set them off to the side. So I didn't particularly like it for that purpose, but I have found that I really like it for the purpose of doing the sprinkle CYOGel. I am using a disposable file system from Tammy Taylor Nails. So I'm using a disposable file system, and maybe I should tap. Maybe if I tap, that'll help. Okay.
Oh, cool.
The cool thing about this, the reason why I cut them in half, besides the fact that it makes it half the price, is, and I'm going to take my edge off my file, is that then I don't tear up my fingers holding it on here. I can hold the file. See if I can get a good spot. I can hold the file, and I'm on the plastic, not on the file grit. And so besides the fact that it's cheaper, it, there we go. I think you guys can see. Can you guys see? Why is that so gross? Okay, let's see if I can get a little less gross. Let's see. Pretty blurry, yes. Okay, let's try this. Let's see if it touched there. There we go. Okay. So the CYOGel, and there is manufacturer support for that. This is a thing that they do and support. So you can use any dipping system powder. I've used it with the back scratchers, and I've used it with New Genesis, and I clearly used it with a failed attempt at using acrylic powder. And so, yeah, I'm just going to sort of prep and finish this off all at the same time. All right. And I'm going to get some corners here so when I put the tip on. And so the reason why I'm using these particular white tips is because I like the fact that they are well-less, so I can put them wherever I want on the nail. I don't have to try and butt it up against, a smile line, or a natural nail. And incidentally, yes, I would be using my e-file for this, except for my sanding mandrel has gone MIA. So I don't have the ability to use anything other than a carbide, which we know we are not supposed to use on the natural nail. So we get hand filing until I either order a new mandrel or find that one. Yeah, it sprouted legs and wandered off. Like, I don't know. I had it earlier in the week, and now it's gone. It just disappeared. So I'm sure it's in that place, you know, that place that I'll find it as soon as I've ordered another one. You know, that's how it normally works. But, and especially because I have a webinar series coming up that I'm gonna have to use it a bunch for, so go figure. Right. So I'm hoping that I don't run out of data while I'm doing this. That would be a bummer. That would be a bummer. All right. Ooh, yeah. This yucky thing. Get off. I have to say, she was super patient with these nails because I have to tell you, I'd have picked them off. Like, that's just in all honesty, like, keeping it real, I would have picked these off.
I tried so hard.
Well, at least we know that we didn't have any lifting issues because you couldn't get them off.
True.
Yeah, I would have totally picked them off. I don't know. Maybe it's just because I'm a nail tech. Like, I'd have figured out a way. Because those were no bueno. Let's see. So, Good times. So yeah, I'm just gonna file this off. I feel like I should be like singing the Jeopardy music or something while I'm doing it. Na 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 na. These were kind enough to already have broken the tips off for me, so, you know.
That's true.
The soaking did remove the tips. So, yeah, it's just a big thing about making sure that you, I don't know, I might not seal, I mean, I will on you, but for a regular express full set, for somebody who's not intending on leaving them on, I may actually use a regular removable sealer that you can just take off with polish remover, because then if they go to soak off, it'll eat right through that quickly. And then if people want to remove at home, they can. All right. Yeah, this is like live real-time nails, huh, guys? Super exciting. Super exciting. Oh, thank goodness I turned the AC on in here. It was so hot earlier.
Sweltery?
Yeah. And it's amazing what changing the thermostat 2 degrees will
do. Yeah, it feels so comfortable in here.
Yeah, it was getting a little warm before. Some of that might have been because I was vacuuming too, but that might have had something to do with it. But and rearranging my furniture.
I know, I like the setup.
Yeah, it's in process. I'm painting this wall tomorrow. And so I needed everything off that wall anyway. And so I was like, okay, well, since I'm going to have to move everything to paint anyway, I might as well move it to where I want it for after it's painted. So yeah, refinishing a bunch of furniture and painting your salon seems like a really good idea until you procure all of said furniture and then have to paint it all at once.
Oh, God.
Yeah. So I have a china cabinet to paint and a whole bunch of other little cabinets, and I have to recover and paint those chairs.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, this is totally my like fixer-upper Holly homemaker project going on down here.
But it'll be exactly how you want it in the end.
Yes, it will. In the end, if I ever get to the end, you start to wonder, you know?
Yes.
So, you guys, I did put a base layer of clear down on these before I did the color. And so that's actually what I'm filing on right now. And so for those of you who see me going, Michelle, isn't that a lot of filing? I'm actually still on product out on this nail right now. So, all right. Oh, so my girls over in the UK, you guys are probably just like sitting at home on your couch watching me. That's got to be interesting. I tried to find a different thing, you guys, to put you in a different holder, but I couldn't find one. So you guys are stuck with this crappy one for right now. I have one for my other cameras, but not for this one. So the good news is that by the time I'm done doing all of this, she will be all prepped too. So that'll be a nice, you know, I'm doing this and it's already going to be, I won't have another step to do afterwards. And this is 180 grit file I'm using. I'm trying to think if there's anything you guys are asking me that I can't see over there. So the CYOGel is really inexpensive. If you've got some dipping system powder sitting around and you don't like the cyanoacrylate resin smell that goes with the other dipping systems, because this is a soak-off gel base, it doesn't have any smell. So that's a good thing. And you know, it cures in the light and all that with photo initiators, so you don't have to worry about you know, brushes that get all sticky because they touch the activator or blah, blah, blah. If you want to try ordering some of the CYOGel to try out for yourself, you can go to CYOGel.com. And if you enter in promo code, are you ready? Ready to write it down? Are you ready? Do you have a piece of paper? Are you ready? Are you ready? Okay, I'm going to say it. The promo code, are you ready? Okay, it is S as in Sam, P-U-G-H as in me, 9532, and that will get you 20% off your orders forever and ever and ever. not just one time. So if you decide to give it a try, make sure you enter that in so you save your 20%. And they do ship internationally. Company has been really great to deal with. The owner guy has been super awesome and super forthcoming with me, answering all my questions. My gosh, your nails grow like a little weed.
They do.
Oh my gosh, I can't believe this. We just did these, like.
Literally too.
Oh my gosh, this is crazy.
Hair and nails like crazy.
Yeah, well, look at your long hair. So bad. Yeah, since I last saw you, I got balayaged.
I like it a lot. I was going to say that.
I feel much, much.
Summery.
Yeah. Well, and she hid my sparkly glitter hairs, you know, so.
No, I really do like it. It complements your skin tone.
Yeah, I feel like it makes me look younger.
It does.
It See, really she does. Said I look younger. That's why I keep bringing her in here for my trials, guys. She's good for my ego. Yeah, I couldn't sleep last night, so at least I got some work accomplished this time when I couldn't sleep, but yeah, so. I've been up for a really long time today.
Dang it.
It's going to be a very long day. It's actually not that bad. I've already been here for 3 or 4 hours.
Okay.
So I'm halfway done with my day. Okay, so while I'm filing, also, you guys, don't forget that starting Monday, the show will be on a weekly format, Mondays, and an hour earlier than the time you're used to watching me. So it'll be on at 1 my time. It'll be longer, probably closer to 90 minutes. And so at least for the summer. And so since I'm sure somebody didn't catch the promo code that I just read again for CYOGel, I'll give it to you again. It is SPUGH9532, and that gets you 20% off forever at CYOGel.com. And so on tomorrow's show, I did some playing, speaking of Chromageddon, I did some playing yesterday with some, CND additives and such that I had, and a micro pigment thing from Wildflowers Academy, and I did it pressed into a just cured heated coat of Shine On from Accents, and I gotta tell ya, it was pretty groovy. So I tried it with a copper color, so I'm interested to try that out a little later. So tomorrow we'll do some playing with those things and see what we can figure out, what our additives and pigments and stuff that we already have, what they will do. Before we go investing in Chromageddon, although I am still going to buy Lauren Weyermann's, the silver chrome. I don't know if I'll get the colored chromes, but I'm definitely going to get the silver chrome because I've been dying for a look like that since minx, but I don't like using minx because it's a hassle. Let's see. Can't think of anything else to talk to you guys about, so I'm just going to keep filing. Oh, I even have music on today, you guys. So you can hear the background music is the theme from the Hatfields and McCoys miniseries. So for you UK people, if you don't know who the Hatfields and the McCoys are, watch it. It's a piece of American history done with some very good actors.
Mm-hmm.
It was really good.
It was really good.
I actually watched the whole miniseries thing twice.
Did you?
And I would totally buy it.
Oh, absolutely. Like, I would
it
too.
It was so good. I didn't know what I was going to think. We just decided to watch the first one and go, well, and if we don't like it, whatever. Mm-hmm. And we were like addicted. Yeah, it's sounding very Wild Westy in here right now.
I love it.
Yeah, that's how much I liked it. I got the song off of iTunes. Yeah, we're listening to music from my phone today on shuffle, and so this is all my personal collection of music, and we have no idea what's going to come up next, so it's like music roulette in the salon. I did just skip over Eminem right before you got here, so I wasn't going to subject you to Eminem, but I like soundtrack songs, apparently, because I have quite a few of those on here. I don't 8 Mile.
I like to like that. That is
a good one. Fast and Furious.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Got a couple, yeah. Got a couple of songs from there. Obviously, the Hatfields and the McCoys. Oh my gosh.
Last one.
I know, right? This is what I get for not taking my e-file and buzzing the sealant off before I put them in the soak-off bags. But this is why we do product trials, right? Because then now I know, so that when I have to do it again, I know what I need to do.
Lesson learned.
Lesson well learned. Well learned. Because I think it's possible that my right arm may fall off. Luckily, these don't require a lot of filing once we're done. Good. So, okay, let's get this messy thing out of here. And it can go bye-bye, and that's why we use a table towel. Okay, make sure we're still in frame. Yep, okay. So let me grab a brush and see what's going on here. Okay, I'm gonna do a little cuticle pushy-pushy to make sure that we are clear for product. Okay. Ooh, Stone Temple Pilots.
I like to.
Yeah, my Amazon Music wasn't working today, and so I was like, eh, we'll just play it off my phone. Which is hilarious that I'm like so excited listening to these songs because I never listen to them, but they're on my phone.
For backup.
Yeah. For those times when you don't have an internet connection.
And yes, or I won't connect to Bluetooth in the car or something either.
Mm-hmm. Totally. All right. Make sure we get what I just did back there. Get all of that. You guys, if I had my Skyber bit handy, I would potentially use my Skyber bit right now, but it's not handy. It's in my back room, so. It would take me longer to go get it than I'm gonna save. So yeah, when I'm done doing this, I will pop back on and do a quick Q&A with you guys, and that way you guys can ask me all the questions that you're wanting to ask me right now, but I can't see the screen. All right. Now I'm gonna take and use some scrub brush here, clean off all this dust and what have you I have going on. You still in frame? Yep, we're still in frame. All right. Boy, this is certainly nothing like the 570 something viewers we had when we were doing the Pass the Polish, huh? Okay. There's a few of you, just a handful of you hardcore folks who are still hanging out here with me. All right, so let's do some tipping. I like that these tips aren't gargantuanly long, too.
Mm-mm.
All right. It gives a nice, pretty smile line. Mm-hmm. Oh. Could be singing right now. There we go. Yeah, these tips are pre-etched, which is a really big deal when you're using whitest white tips, because I don't need to run my file over them to remove the shine off of the tip, so it will adhere. So that's Oh, we're gonna listen to Frozen now. Another movie. I know, I feel like I should turn this up. We can all just rock out to Frozen soundtrack. Too big. Just trying to see if I can use one of the ones I had sitting here, but no. Sing it, Idina Menzel. Oh, I need to go to Disneyland. We say in my house when it's nice and sunny outside like this, our Disneyitis flares up.
It does big time.
So my Disneyitis is just going full force right now. And it's really hard because I can look out the window and see I-5. And I know that if I just got on that road and drove south,
yes, just follow
me there. like I am literally like two turns away from Disneyland. I mean, and about 1,100 miles, but two turns.
Seriously, though, I know it makes it so convenient.
I'm like, oh. Of course, I'm really just dreaming today because I even rode the bus here. I don't have my car here today.
You did?
Yeah, so. And I gave a girl bus money today.
Oh my goodness.
She must live in my apartment complex, but she, you know, we were just standing there, idle chit chat at the bus stop, and she was in scrubs, like she was getting ready clearly to go to work.
Yeah.
And she was like, dang it, I forgot my bus ORCA card. I forgot my bus pass, and I don't have time to go back because if I go back to my apartment and get it, then I'll be late for work, and so I'm at least gonna have to try and see if maybe the bus driver will just let me on. And so I dug around in my purse and found $2 worth of change, and
oh my gosh,
she was very grateful.
Oh, I bet though.
She was like, oh my gosh, thank you. And I was like, see, this is when we just continually dump change in our purse, this is what happens. That's what that change is good for.
Comes in handy.
Yep. I was like, girl, we've all been there.
Mm-hmm.
We've all been there. So pay it forward.
That's true.
Someday she'll pay the $2 bus fare for somebody. You guys are really lucky that I'm not singing right now. Like, everybody is really lucky I'm not singing right now. Y'all have no idea how lucky you are I'm not singing right now. Because when you listen to the depth of my voice, I clearly cannot sing as high as Dina Menzel. So, it would be no bueno. No bueno. And make sure when you're customizing white tips, you guys, you make sure that you don't like erase your smile line. So you have to be careful. Careful with the white tips. Okay, see, I don't even know what this song is. I'm thinking that maybe it was one of the Starbucks free downloads.
That's what I was wondering, like, whether it came from.
So I should probably go through and do some house cleaning on my iTunes, but like I said, it's always entertaining, right? Never a dull moment here at Nails by Michelle. Okay. Oh my God, that is the most awful sound ever when those...
Like nails edge... on a chocolate.
Yeah, except for it's nails on a plastic tip case.
Yes.
Yuck. Okay. One last tip. All right. Everybody still here? Yep. Oh, we lost one. We're down to six in the chat. Okay, so we're gonna put those away. And put that over there. All right. Look at that trained cosmetologist. knows the drill. Always seems like such a waste of plastic.
I know.
But it's way easier to cut down length than it is too. Okay. Well, this little guy is still way too long. And then we'll put a little bit of artsy stuff on him when we're all done. Give him a little flair so they're not just plain French.
Perfect.
All right. And then I'm going to put my protein bond on. Just the natural nail. I used protein bond before and it worked fine. So I'm going to use protein bond again. Because we definitely did not have a problem with them staying on.
No.
Look at that. See, there's still some remnants of red.
Isn't that weird? Like it bonded to me.
I know, right? Like, come up there. You can't seal any of this little reddy pinky stuff in here. So for anybody just tuning in, I'm not doing this because I need to prep the white tip. I'm doing this because somehow we've managed to get some red action going on in here. Okay. All right, so now I'm going to bring my light over here and we're going to do, is it still in frame? Okay, and we're going to do a coat of the CYOGel base. And this was something I learned from last time too, was actually to put down a base without any sprinkle. Which I really kind of like, especially when I'm doing a white tip, because it's one more little coat that helps level out that difference between the white tip. Right. Are we having fun yet, guys? Okay, into the light you go.
Okay.
And so after I do this, I think I'm going to do a coat that is just on the nail bed part so that I can help, and then do the powder so I can help bring that level up. So we have a little more even of a surface for when I sprinkle over the whole nail. Powder out here, so I have my powder. Oh, we're down to five, we lost another one. Okay, so guys, here's how this works. You put on the CYOGel, and in this case, I'm putting it just on the nail because I want it, and then you pour it over. That's simple. That simple. Isn't this little scoop fun?
It is, though. It makes it so easy.
There we go. And it takes a little bit of time for the CYO gel to combine with the powder, which is why I'm dipping one nail at a time so that it has an opportunity to sort of soak in while I'm going on to the next nail. And no smell. Yeah, I say we. I wish the cameras had smell so you guys could know that there's no smell. Yeah, this is going to be quite a bit different for you than
last time.
In the last time. Goodness knows, I hope. Okay, now the switch. Perfect. I did my daughter's with the light pink powder. I bought one powder. Yeah, it looks kind of, it's like the color of ballet slippers.
Really?
It's okay. Really, really pretty and a little shimmery. So maybe we'll, when it's time to fill your nails, we'll fill it with that and see how it just all, you know, goes together.
Oh, that would be cool.
And then it'll sort of hide where your natural nail is visible through the grow outline.
Okay.
So it'll probably still be able to see the white tip, but you won't be able to see anything else.
Awesome, awesome.
Some of these companies have like a gazillion colors. I would love to be able to buy like all of them, but of course there's a lot. And that's expensive.
So a couple cool new ones each season.
That's kind of, yeah. I think I'm going to have to stick with clear and polish, you know,
For
people who want color until I can add more dipping colors.
Yeah. That was a really pretty one last time, just to try to.
Yeah, I think that because that color was so pretty, I think when I do get to ordering a new color, I think I'm going to find a color like that because it was really pretty. Okay, go ahead and switch.
It was cool in the sunlight. It really, really shimmered opalescent-y too.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
All right. So, yeah, you can see it's quite a bit more level now. I'm going to put another coat on. Actually, just a little bit. There we go. So pretty. Mm-hmm. These, for white tips, these have such a pretty smile line. It's very smiley. Makes your nails very happy. Mm-hmm. Thank you for spending some of your day off with me.
Absolutely. Thank you for fitting me in.
You have such pretty pink nail beds that even using the clear, like it looks pink still. Like they look pink and white because you have such pink nail beds.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that'll be pretty then.
Yeah. It's looking really good already so far. Yeah, I think we spent most of our time getting your old ones off.
I think so.
I wonder if I've run out of data yet.
I didn't even think of that.
Well, a lot of times when I'm down here, I'm on Wi-Fi, but
I'm not
right now, so the Wi-Fi is
unreliable.
Will that charge
you up the ball
soon,
then?
Nah.
Okay.
All right, and switch. Oh, we got somebody back. We're back up to six. You guys see good? Yeah, you guys can see pretty good. Mm-hmm. Anyway, yeah, this is a whole lot like putting on polish, which is super cool. Mm-hmm. I'm not super impressed with how this tip fit. Mm-hmm. Tips are such a pain. I mean, they're easy once you get them on, but the getting them on part is...
With everybody's fingers.
Well, and I never understand why tips are the first thing they teach you how to do in nail school.
Oh. I
think because they somewhere along the line think it's easier, but I mean, tips require just as much practice.
Oh, I bet.
As sculpture to get them.
Different. Mm-hmm. Why then? Yeah.
You're gonna go to work tomorrow and your coworkers gonna be like, oh, look at your new pretty nails.
I know. I'm excited.
Switch. I'm going to take a look here and see what I need. And yes, I need one more coat. Activity outside the little door here of my salon that I'm like, there was a guy who went by with a big old pallet of something earlier. I don't even know where he was going with that pallet, and then he went back by and it was empty. I'm like, whatever he did, he...
That's weird down here.
Yeah.
That parking lot was packed up there too when I got in.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That must be just a busy day in the building. And I didn't even drive, so my car's not even taking up one of those parking spots. I feel so carbon neutral.
You know, give me back.
Feel so carbon neutral.
Is it a quick ride for you at least?
No, not really. But today I had to get off the bus at the grocery store so I could go in and pick up my prescription and then get back on the next one that came by. So I want some mad props. I went into Fred Meyer, which is like a grocery all one-stop shopping store here for those of you who are watching from elsewhere. They have groceries and other things. And I went in and I picked up my prescription. And I went and returned something that I needed to return. And I went and grabbed like three things, checked out, and still had like 10 minutes to wait for the bus. I know, I was like speedy, speedy. Yep, I was, and I had to cross the street to get to the store and back to get to the side of the street where the bus was going to come on.
The one on 72nd?
No, I was on the one on 19th.
Okay.
19th and Stevens there.
I was going to say, dang it, if I was closer to the end, I'd just give you a ride home.
Oh, nah. Thank you, though.
Yeah.
I don't mind riding the bus. It's always interesting.
It so is.
You definitely learn a lot about society. My husband, not a bus rider, so I've had to remind him on more than one occasion that the people on the bus can hear you if you're saying something, because he is real quick to go, you know, are you kidding me? And I'm like, shh, they can hear you. It's like, don't care. It was a really funny story of which I can't do it justice, but a guy got on the bus and it was dark and it was by Tacoma General.
Oh gosh.
And he had ski goggles on.
What?
But like not like new ski goggles, like yellow tinted 1975 Olympic team ski goggles. And I was trying to be all nice, going, you know, well, maybe he just got done with like some eye surgery and they said you can't be out, because it was really like nasty outside.
Oh.
And so maybe they said you can't have that, you know, and but he doesn't ski, so he just went and bought like a $1 pair of goggles from Value Village or something for the purpose of this appointment.
Yeah.
But
My husband thought it was much more likely that he was just kind of a weirdo and wanted to wear goggles.
In the nighttime.
In the nighttime. Switch, so, eh.
Yes, it's definitely free entertainment.
Yes, yes it is. All right, we'll get all this stuff out of the way.
Okay.
I'm gonna grab a towel because I've managed to get this. Oh, Adam Levine.
Mm-hmm. Such a babe.
Yeah.
Such a babe. Babe-tastic. So, and you guys, there's no, since there's acrylic powder, there's no sticky residue. So, I'm going to do some final shaping here. Yeah, of course, we're listening to the unedited version too, you know. So Andrea, I don't know if you're still with us, but if you are, this would be the same kind of thing you could do with your slick pour. So if I didn't make you mad by telling you to not ask about prices in Facebook groups. She might have abandoned me because terms of time repetitious. Oh my goodness, so much better. This is so much better than the last trap.
Yeah, very, very even. Pour over each one.
Yes, that's definitely, it's just a reminder that you just can't dip because you push.
That's what it
gels.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
I learned that with my when I did my daughter's after I did yours.
Okay.
I dipped in and I was able that time like to actually watch it push the gel up, and I was like, oh, duh.
Okay.
All right. Oh, much better. Okay, let's go ahead and take this one. In this one, you can tell it still had a little too much gel on this one side because it's still sticky, whereas the other ones aren't sticky. Oh, well, got to hear my cursing on my radio. Hey, it's my personal iTunes, man. I can have the explicit version.
You can.
So, I'm interested to hear from you guys when I'm done filing here. I'm interested to hear from you guys what you think about the whole process. I think we spent the majority of the time getting the other ones off because I didn't break the seal. But once we started doing the application on this, it went by pretty quickly. Mm-hmm. Oh, now we can listen to some Britney. Get it, Britney.
Right. So happy she turned her life back around.
I know. She was a hot mess for a while there. All right. And these are pretty even and pretty smooth. I just am basically filing for a little bit of shape here. These actually, because of the way the white smile line is and stuff, they look very natural.
Mm-hmm. They really do.
Be careful that I don't file off your little corners of your white line there. Oh, I miss my e-file right now. Because this would be a real simple just buzz, buzz, buzz.
Mm-hmm. Do you have a full rest of the evening?
I do, pretty much.
Make it go by quick.
It does make it go by quick. It's kind of like having a bunch of people come over to your house mm-hmm. all day, you know? And yeah. so it's you get to visit with different people.
In and out, in and out.
In and out. New nails, new stories.
Mm-hmm. That's true.
Wonder if there's some like weirdos out there with like a fingernail fetish who just like watch all of this stuff on Periscope. I mean, it seems like it would be heaven for people like mm-hmm. that, you know?
No, truthfully.
They don't have to go in anywhere. They can just tune in.
Especially the feet guys.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I haven't really done any pedicure demos on Periscope, okay. so I hadn't really thought about that, but now that I think about it, I don't know that I will, because, yeah, that would be kind of creepy weird, and there's already, like, the UK people, you call them wankers, there's always the wankers that pop on and, like, say obnoxious things, and then we block them, yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Although they, I'm sure, would have been excited to know they'd have gotten no reaction if they had said something awful right now, because I haven't been able to see.
That's true.
So they can pretty much say whatever they want. So yeah, this nail, I could tell, had a little more gel, like, on this side. It must have, like, drifted a little, which is good to know that it still can
do that.
Run off somewhere. All right. I'm going to be really surprised if I don't run out of data. So, guys, if I end abruptly, it's because I ran out of data. Yeah, so this one had kind of a weird little thing going on here. I think I filed it out. Clarkson now. We've got some girl power music going on right now. I wonder if everybody who's watching just feels like they're just like hanging out in the salon with us right now.
I know.
I mean, it would be a little different. I suppose it's not like if they were here in the salon, their nose would be sitting right where the camera is. So it is a little bit different angle than they would have even if they were here. But so yeah, this is a service that's going to be offered at $30.
Wow.
So
that's very reasonable.
Yeah, you know, that's, well, and because in typically in that price point, you know, you get tips. Mm-hmm. And a lot of times it's white tips, you know what I mean? Or true. Regular tips and polish. And so that's, I was trying to come up with a service that I could do in enough of a time and with product cost, you know, back to that pricing thing to be able to offer.
And then what would the bill on that
be? It'll be 20.
Okay.
Plus, depending on how many repairs, you know, there'll be, you know, a couple dollars extra if there's repairs. But so, yeah, it's one of those just, you know, the, it's exciting. I'm excited to be able to offer this for my spray tanning, airbrush tanning gun will be here this week.
And oh, so no I'm excited way. You about have that. One of those too?
Yeah, I'm airbrush tan trained. So,
will you do spray tans mm-hmm. here? Oh, will you let me know then? Because yeah. I will. Okay.
Yeah. And so I'm doing I'm putting together a package.
Okay.
That will be, it's called Beach Vacation.
Okay.
And it is basically getting your toes, you know, clip, file, polish, all that. A set of nails like this.
Okay.
And an airbrush can.
Wow.
So that way for people who just, you know, want to have potty looking.
Have you set stuff. A price point for that?
Because all total they would be $115, and I think okay. I'm doing it for $110.
Wow.
Just give a little bit of a discount for them being all done at once.
Okay. Wow, that would be so fun.
So people who just want to, or you know, you just have an event or something.
Yeah.
You know? So. All right. So, I'm going to just show you guys these here, and then I'm going to do a couple little bit of later. No, I don't need the software update. Okay, so I'm going to give you guys a little look here, and then I'll put pictures up of the after I add a little bit of art to them and put the top gel on. So there we go. There is the final before a little bit of art and top gel. So that's that. And then I'll have pictures up for you that I'll put on the Facebook page for Nails Over Coffee. So I made it look so easy. It is easy. It's just requires some practice. You know, these still by no means are perfect. They're definitely better than I've done before, but they're by no means perfect. So this is why even after 20 years, when you're trying a new product or you're trying a new service, that it's really important for you to make sure that you've got it good for your clients. All right, so I will see you guys tomorrow. We'll do some pigment trials and such. And if you want to catch this on the replay, it'll be on the replay. And I'm probably not going to upload videos until this weekend when the kids are gone and not hogging bandwidth at the house. All right, so thanks for joining in, you guys. And I'll see you tomorrow. Same bat time, same bat channel. Bye.